Struggles, challenges, and hard times offer us much more value than any other time in our life. We cannot grow without struggles and cannot get stronger without resistance. Hello everyone. Today, we the Great 9C are here to tell you all about the current crisis, coronavirus. First of all, we need to know what is coronavirus. So, coronavirus COVID-19 pandemic is the defining global health crisis of our time and the greatest challenge we have faced. The virus has spread to every continent except Antarctica. Cases are rising daily in Africa, the Americas, and Europe. The pandemic is moving like a wave, one that may yet crash on those least able to cope. After knowing this, the question that strikes our mind is that, from where did it originate? Most of us know that it came from Wuhan, China, on December 31st. COVID-19 is thought to have originated in a seafood market where wildlife was sold illegally. Scientists have pointed to either bats or snakes as possible sources. The WHO declared the virus a pandemic on March 11th and said it was deeply concerned by the alarming levels of spread and severity of the outbreak. Hope is the most important factors when it comes to overcoming life's biggest challenges. So, we should never believe in giving up and hope for the best to happen. Thank you.
Welcome to all. Today I'm here to brief you all about the effects of COVID-19 or coronavirus. The coronavirus outbreak, which was first detected in China, has infected people in 185 countries. Firstly, I would like to say that this virus affects the respiratory system of humans. And if we compare the 2020 and 19 mortality rates, it shows that more people are dying this year as compared to last year due to the outbreak of COVID-19. It has also affected the economy of many countries. For example, big shifts in stock markets where shares and companies are bought and sold can affect the value of pensions or individual saving accounts. The Dow and FTSE saw their biggest quarterly drops in the first 3 months of the year since 1987. The investors also fear spread of the coronavirus will destroy economic growth and the government action may not be enough to stop the decline. It has also affected the education system, as most of the government around the world have temporarily closed educational institutions in an attempt to contain the spread of COVID-19 pandemic. These nationwide closures are impacting almost 70% of the world's student population. Several other countries have implemented localized closures impacting millions of additional learners. It has also been found that as people prefer to stay home and keep themselves safe, it is also keeping the environment safe. As a result of it, the air quality improved largely because of a reduction in factory and road traffic emissions of carbon dioxide, nitrogen oxide, and related zones, formations, and particulate matter. Thank you. Millions of additional learners. It has also been found that as people prefer to stay home and keep themselves safe, it is also keeping the environment safe. As a result of it, the air quality improved largely because of a reduction in factory and road traffic emissions of carbon dioxide, nitrogen oxide, and related zones, formations, and particulate matter. Thank you.
Good afternoon to everyone. I am here to speak about the precaution of coronavirus. For this, we need to first understand what is coronavirus. Coronavirus are a large family of viruses. They are known to cause illness ranging from common cold to more severe diseases such as Middle East Respiratory Syndrome, MERS, and Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome, SARS. Now, I shall share with y'all some of the most common symptoms of COVID-19. They are fever, dry cough, tiredness. Here are some of the less common symptoms also. They are ache and pain, sore throat, diarrhea, conjunctivitis, headache, loss of smell and taste, discoloration of finger and toes. You can reduce your chances of being infected or spreading of COVID-19 by taking some simple precautions. They are, number one, regularly and thoroughly clean your hands with an alcohol-based hand rub or wash them with soap and water. They help us to kill the germs in our hand. Number two, maintain at least 1 meter, 3 feet distance between yourself and others. Number three, avoid going to crowded places. Number four, avoid frequent touching of your eyes, nose and mouth. Number five, make sure you and the others around you follow good respiratory hygiene. That is, they cover their mouth with the elbow or a tissue when they sneeze or cough. Lastly, stay home and self-isolated even when major symptoms such as cough, headache, mild fever until you recover. Our government is working very hard to get rid of this coronavirus. We have to help them. It is us who can end this. And for that, we need to come together as one and work towards it. Thank you. Good afternoon to everyone. I am here to speak about the precaution of coronavirus. For this, we need to first understand what is coronavirus. Coronavirus are a large family of viruses. They are known to cause illness ranging from common cold to more severe diseases such as Middle East Respiratory Syndrome, MERS, and Severe Acute Respiratory Syndrome, SARS. Now, I shall share with y'all some of the most common symptoms of COVID-19. They are fever, dry cough, tiredness. Here are some of the less common symptoms also. They are ache and pain, sore throat, diarrhea, conjunctivitis, headache, loss of smell and taste, discoloration of finger and toes. You can reduce your chances of being infected or spreading of COVID-19 by taking some simple precautions. They are, number one, regularly and thoroughly clean your hands with an alcohol-based hand rub or wash them with soap and water. They help us to kill the germs in our hand. Number two, maintain at least 1 meter, 3 feet distance between yourself and others. Number three, avoid going to crowded places. Number four, avoid frequent touching of your eyes, nose and mouth. Number five, make sure you and the others around you follow good respiratory hygiene. That is, they cover their mouth with the elbow or a tissue when they sneeze or cough. Lastly, stay home and self-isolated even when major symptoms such as cough, headache, mild fever until you recover. Our government is working very hard to get rid of this coronavirus. We have to help them. It is us who can end this. And for that, we need to come together as one and work towards it. Thank you.